can start now. We will start the recording right now.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Pemela Massa from Tanzania, working at the East African Legislative Assembly as a member of parliament. Professionally, I'm an engineer and I'm also a public health specialist. Today, I'll be presenting to you the topic saying that environment and the SDG, telling the success stories from Africa. Looking at the SDG themselves, you all understand that they were built from the decades of work by countries and also in collaboration with the United Nations through its Department of Economic and Social Affairs. We all know that more than 178 countries adopted the agenda, which is the Agenda 21, so that they can have the comprehensive plan to build a global partnership. And we all understand that also we have the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, which aims to ensure that the SDGs covers the social, economic, and environmental dimensions for development. Looking at the African point of view, we all know that Africa is divided into sub-regions, but in general, it is blessed with rich and diverse environmental resources. Looking at the different resources which we have in Africa, we all understand that they have a significant and a very relevant to the lives of people in Africa. And considering the importance of all these resources also, we understand that we need to implement, there is a need to implement the SDGs so that they can reach the target, especially aiming to get the sustainable environment, which stimulates the economic growth and the poverty reduction in Africa. This was the source from the UNEP. And you also know that citizens in Africa, they have different practices, which in one way or another, they aim to development, but on the other side, they affect the environment. These activities are like farming, forest activities, mining, infrastructure activities, water, fishing, and many, many others. Also, the issues to do with having the proper housing, getting the energy, the issues of looking at employment, all these are the issues which in one way or another affect the environment sector. Also, we can see we have this 2030 agenda for development, and we are expecting that we shall get the Africa we want by implementing all this with their strategies. As well as we have also the 5 African development pillars, which aimed also to get them to reach the environmental sustainability, natural resources, and also the issue to do with the disaster risk management. About 90% of the African countries have been mainstreamed to the SDGs, and in these development plans within the nations, they have made some significant gains with in an environmental perspective. Looking at the way these SDGs are linked with the different dimensions in the communities, we can see the SDGs direct, they aim to deal with the economic, social, and environmental dimensions, of which are very wide. If you want to talk one by one, it is really a long story. But in summary, you can see the role of environment in achieving the SDGs in some Sub-Saharan area, especially the southern part and the eastern part of Africa, and also the environmental issues The central to the higher and the transformation, but you cannot, we cannot cycle it with the environmental management and poverty, which can lead to unstable development. Looking at the scarce resources, which we are lacking as an as Africans, we really need to get the attention from government across Africa and other stakeholders, which will need to address the issue of environmental problem. The African Agenda of 2016 and the SDGs, they provide excellent opportunities in advancing the development prospects. Also, we can see the 2020 Africa SDG Index and the dashboard report mentioned about the issue, the involvement of African governments, which made a significant effort to endorse the SDGs, especially in the incorporating them into national strategies and development planning. Most of the countries identified the units which can coordinate and implement the specific targets and the indicators which are coming from the SDGs. Now, the role of women in the environment, you could see in the SDG, you could see they played different roles to make sure that they, in one way or another, they affect or they touch the lives of people. And now you see the way women manage natural resources in family and community levels, but sometimes they think that they are saving the community, but on the other side, they're affecting the environment. And you see around the world, women also manage water, source of fuel, food, forests, and many, many other terrains which affect the environment. And this is according to Global Women's Issue under chapter 11. And 60 to 80% of food in developing countries also are one of the issues which, no, I think here there is a mistake. We have the 6 to 80% of food which are being produced mostly by women. And you can see the way they inherit, and also women inherit the laws and the local customs which prevent them from owning and leasing the land. The movements of women towards environment and the SDGs, we can see there are several movements which have been done by women, especially from the 2-century-long. And during the implementation of whatever they are doing, especially these movements, there are lots of challenges which women get when they want to implement these movements. But it grows significantly after Industrial Revolution, where you can see there is an increase of environmental pollution and degradation, especially in water and airways. But looking at this, also the movement of women, we could see there are many also conservation groups which were formed. One of them is the Emergence Conservation Committee, which were formed, and it brought a lot of results. And I failed to share the data, but if you allow me in the last minutes, I can share the data on how it brought the impact in. Now, looking at the direct to Africa on how this movement is impacting, you can see we have a group of 3 activists in Africa who are helping to lead the way in advocating for environmental issues and climate justice. And most of these activists, you can see they are following the movement which were initiated by the late Wangari Maathai in 1970s, which we all understand that, and we appreciate that she paved the way for the new generation. Also, we could see many countries like Tanzania, Ethiopia, Rwanda, Namibia, Uganda have taken the same direction. For example, in Tanzania, we have the blue economy programs and the plastic use ban, which is already in place. So we really appreciate that there are some progress. Yeah. These are just some examples of the movements in Africa, environmental movements in Africa, which some of them are being led by me. These are students from primary school, where we are trying to give them the awareness on the environmental and climate change issues to, so that they can understand the issues from the grassroots. You can see the we even tried to even get the small kids so that they participate in different actions so that they get the awareness. We have the linkage between women and environment. We all know that we cannot do away with the role women plays towards the environment. And there are different international agreements which were moved by women. And some of them, you can see there are convention on the elimination of all forms of discrimination against women. Also, there is a Beijing platform for action, as well as there are issues which were overshadowed to different impact global warming, which would have on women and men, which is now evident. Also, you could see some, there are some pictures of women doing movements, environmental movements, climate change issues, because you all understand these are very sensitive issues, which really needs to be advocated and need to be addressed. Also, these are the movements which are ongoing in Tanzania, doing the planting of trees, forestation, all these movements are ongoing. Then we are proceeding with some of the conventions which were taken by women. We also see the UNF summit, which produced two conventions in biological diversity, and also to combat desertification, which guided the implementation of environmental action from gender perspective. Now, looking at the SDGs with the environment, we can see also around the 17 SDGs with its target, there are a lot of interlinkage between the SDGs and the environment. Some of the SDGs which interlink directly with the environment are those ones which are natural resource management, climate change, water-related issues, marine issues, industry, innovation and the infrastructure, the biodiversity and the ecosystems, circular economy, which are all environmentally sound, and also managing the chemicals which are being used during the infrastructure, especially on the side of when they are treating the roads or when the chemicals are being used in the agriculture sector. These are the same interlinkage which are indicated here, showing that how the SDGs interlink with the environment, and it mentions from the SDG number 6, which talks about the issues of water, and the SDG number 7 is the issues of energy, and it aims to increase sustainability to share the renewable energy in global energy. And also we have SDG 13, which is about the climate change. You can see the climatic issues, the way it affects the environment. So all these SDGs mentioned about the environmental issues. Also SDG number 14, which is the issues to do with the oceans and marines and how the sustainable development can be achieved. And also we have the issues to do with the terrestrial ecosystems, the forest and many, many others, including the biodiversity and land, getting the reverse land degradation. And the last one is the, I think I've mentioned it already from in the previous slide. Now, what are we aiming to achieve having this environment aspects which are being linked by the SDG? First of all, you can see that we're aiming to end with no poverty, getting the zero hunger, improved good health and well-being of human beings, getting the quality education through these people getting the awareness, and then once they are aware of what is supposed to be done, they can provide it to our children in a quality way. And also the last thing is having the sustainable infrastructure and the industry and innovation. We all know, we understand that once every SDG considers the environmental aspect and take into consideration the impact and the advantage of having, of protecting the environment, we can achieve this. But apart from this achievement, we can see also by the having women involved in these interlinkage SDGs with the environment, also we have majority of women who get to understand, who understands these environmental issues, and they are participating. Since we as leaders who already understand the impact of environment, we are providing with a lot of information, and also we're trying to educate some of the young people, especially the young girls, understand the role of women in the community. And why do we say that once a woman understand these issues, it's very easy to educate the whole community. Then also there are some priorities which were set by SDGs, and they were divided into sub-regionals. I will not go into deep on that because they talk of the same thing about the implementation of the SDGs from North Africa, West Africa, Central Africa, Eastern Africa, and Southern Africa. But we had a drafted report which was deliberated by the African Regional Consultative Meeting on SDGs. And this report is the one which indicated the status of this sub-regional implementation of the SDGs. Now, coming to the achievement of the SDGs, we all understand that we need to get the integrated movement or integrated partnership between the government, private sector, civil society, and the citizen to understand these SDGs so that we all move together to reach the better future. We know that SDG must be implemented in an integrated way so that we can help the country also to tackle the complex challenges and lay out a more sustainable future for the African generation. Addressing the challenges, also, you cannot address the challenge caused by the implementation of SDG without interlinking and without integrating the SDGs with the issues to do with the environment. Also, we see that SDG must be implemented in an integrated way, which can help to tackle the complex challenges of which I've mentioned it already. And also now looking at most challenges, we have many challenges, but I'll talk about four challenges. One of the challenges we see is the governance issue. So, because if we don't have a good governance in place, we can be affected with the political issues and sometimes being blocked by the political movement. So we have the issues to do with the governance framework that they have to cover the SDGs. Also, we are lacking the clarity and clarification when we are doing the reporting or the implementation of SDGs. And also in African countries, we are missing the accountability issues where the accountability mechanism is still challenged. Also, the people are not being responsible to their roles. And another challenge is having the mechanism of reporting, whereby we could see up to 2018, only 19 African countries we are reporting the existing mechanism of the SDGs, which we can see is a big gap, and it really needs to be addressed. The last challenge we're having is a compromising comparability between the reporting mechanism, which are not of the same standard. And I think this is another gap which needs to be addressed, because if the reporting mechanism is not of the same standard, that means everyone will be reporting what he or she feels to report. And sometimes maybe people might be hiding something or might be hiding the problem, and then the aim or targets of SDGs might not be implemented. And then looking at the progress which has reached by African countries, yes, there are some progress, especially enrolling women, more children in primary school, particularly girls. Also, there is an increase in representation of women in national parliaments, reducing child and maternal death. And also, we have got the proportion of people who are looking at the proportion of people who are infected with HIV. And looking at this progress, several countries have taken the step to deal with the SDGs by integrating them into their national plans, which is a good progress. Also, we can see that since getting the sustainable development, we depend on goods and services which are derived from the environmental and the natural resources base. The environment and natural resources are very crucial to the region, to the region's effort, which will eradicate the poverty, and it is linked to the social dimensions, which is healthy, gender, and food security. Then looking at the consumption and production patterns, which are based in the resources, also it determines the pace of sustainable development. Again, looking at the progress which have made so far, we see poverty is on the decline in many countries, and the public expenditures on education and health are steadily increasing, as well as there is a very encouraging on health, gender and women's empowerment indicators. Although there is a very considerable challenges which are remaining. These are some countries which they have made progress in the implementing the SDGs. However, poverty, inequality, and extreme hunger remain fundamental challenges. These were the reports of 2015, which appears under development frameworks. There are some recent reports also indicating the African implementation of SDGs, which are not going to much into it, but still we have people who are still living under this very poor life in Africa. So it's a risky to the continent. Then looking at the integrated approach in water resources, we see there is agriculture, forest, and the other extractive, which include the mainstreaming of gender and governance issues. Also, we have done the capacity building of policymakers and technical staff in SDGs in general, and SDGs related to environment. Also, there is a success in partnership for environment across Africa. It touches the issues of financing, the programs which emerged to do the environmental issues and so forth. These are just examples which emerged during the budgeting. For example, they are bringing plans and budgets for environment, the National Integrated Environment, the cross sector for Then I'll give you some looking at the success stories. at the planning and budgeting side, no? Looking at the budget success story on the projecting, you see there is a climate smart agriculture, which is the project which was initiated. Also, we have the issues which address the economic, environmental, and social aspect, where the economic perspective increased sector contribution to GDP at a national level. At the environmental side, we see the sustainable technologies to address the soil erosion. And the last one, on the social sector, agriculture, gender gap, income for inequalities, nutrition and health issues also were addressed. So these are the success stories from the implementation of project. Another project which was addressed is the forest and fuel energy, whereby we see it is divided into three also on how it impacts the economic, environmental, and the social aspect. Now we have the environmental challenges in Africa. I didn't mention a lot. We have a lot, but I'll just mention the two of them that, despite the gains and the existence of different framework for environmental issues, African environment and natural resources are under continuous, they are under threat, and it forms a vicious cycle on poverty, environment poverty. Also, there is an estimated financial cost of environmental degradation, which is very high, which range from 4 to 5% of GDP in Malawi, to 21% in Mali. Also, I tried to look at the challenges amid COVID-19 because now we understand that we are in this situation, we are in the current situation whereby we are fighting the pandemic. So I thought it's better to talk about the challenges amid COVID-19. So you can see there are a lot of them, but they include lack of effective leadership that we all understand that this pandemic has exacerbated inequalities and injustice in society, especially SDGs have been trying to reduce and other challenges that existed in pre-pandemic times. And it continues to hinder the realization of SDGs. So we have the breakdown of multilateralism and the rise in nationalist tendency. We also understand that we are having the lack of adequate and predictable finance, which means that the countries cannot distribute their resources dealing with the environmental issues, implementation of SDGs, and at the same time, they are fighting with this pandemic. And also we have another challenge which requires us to go digital, which is bringing the negative impact, especially getting the in data collection, because now getting the information about what is really happening to the across the continent, it becomes more challenge because someone cannot go into the field or cannot go somewhere physically to get the data. Then looking at the opportunities which were brought by these challenges, you can see vibrant youth population we're getting the vibrant youth population in the developing world, especially Africa and Asia. Also the technological leapfrog in developing countries, especially the telecommunication and the service sector. Also, we can get the enhanced and continued empowerment of women and the girls. And the last opportunity, which I didn't mention here, is women and especially young generation to take the opportunities to become innovative, to do the business, online business, and doing business, getting online services of supplying goods and services in general. So that were not included. So on the last, I would like to pose the question to the participant that what is the way forward after looking at these, the above mentioned challenges, and also the impact which are being brought by the pandemic situation towards the implementation of SDGs. And in conclusion, despite the widespread of adoption and the progress towards the sustainable goals in Africa, we all know that Africa still lags behind the development, because we all know these challenges are not easy to be tackled at once. So we know that we are still lagging behind. And although significant progress were done on some of the SDGs, still environmental issues, if are not kept as a priority, sometimes women cannot implement themselves, or all the stakeholders, including others, especially the young generation, might not understand it. And the last one is the some of political and social movements which are addressing environment has become a threat to the health and livelihood of people, because we all understand these practices are really good, but on the other hand, they are affecting the people of the community, because in one end you are doing the deforestation, on the other side you are doing the movement. So I think this is something which needs to be addressed. And the very last point is the environmental challenges are very capable of undermining the SDGs in Africa. This is something which we really need to understand, but we cannot ignore that the SDGs on the other side, it brings many, many development in Africa. With saying so, thank you for listening.
Thank you so much, Your Excellency. We enjoyed such wonderful presentation about environment and SDGs. And I guess there are some participants who would like to ask you some questions. So if you allow us, we will give them the floor.
Yes, of course.
Go ahead.
Good afternoon, Your Excellency.
Good afternoon, madam.
Welcome. I have two questions. My first question is that what is the legal implications for all those things, for all what you've explained, the non-compliance of the SDGs? My second question is that there is a project going on brought by the African Development Bank, known as the Feed the African strategy. So, what is the role of the SDGs in this project? That's my question. Thank you.
Okay, sorry to ask you. The second question, you said that the project is going on and it was brought by the FDB and
African Development Bank.
Yes, what is
the aim? It was launched in 2015. Fit the African strategy.
Okay.
It's done by the African Development Bank. So my question here is that what is the role of the SDGs in this type of project? Is it a sustainable one, or is something for a just short time?
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm. Are we going to allow all participants who have raised their hands to ask all the questions, or I respond one by one?
Whatever is convenient for you, you decide which way you would like to go.
I think it's better I collect all of them and then I answer.
Definitely. So who else would like to ask Her Excellency another question? Go ahead, Hazel. Would you please stop screen sharing so that we can see you?
Okay, no problem.
Suzanne? Yes? Go ahead, Suzanne.
Thank you very much for this very great presentation. Your Excellency, we are happy with this presentation. And I particularly liked the concept of smart agriculture. And I would like to know what measures you are putting in place to make sure that the concept of smart agriculture can grow to many communities and to many nations, because I really see this is a very promising strategy. Thank you.
Okay.
Go ahead. Halima, if you like to ask.
Michael.
Go ahead.
Yes, I'm Dr. Edna Moy. Mine is not a question, Your Excellence, but it is a proposal, because you are in a better position for policy implementation and policy making. I would suggest that for women to actually be at par in such challenges and pandemic to affect these SDGs, then one, we should have involvement and empowerment of women. Policies that are very clear for involvement of women and also empowering women. And two, to have the new financial and progressive monitoring and evaluation, so that again, we know money answered all things. If women are not also empowered to have money, then they are likely not to add anything on the progress. Thank you. Thank you, Your Excellence.
Thank you, Edna.
Who else? Halima, you're okay to go. You can ask your question.
So what do you mean if I
can? Yes, we can hear you. Go ahead, Halima. So, Hazel, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, go ahead.
Yes, I wanted to ask on the let's say, looking at women with the environment, how best can we help them? Since they're the ones that who are on the ground with the family, unlike with men, how can they help in order to reduce, or how can they help so that they don't go or they don't tamper with the environment? Since if we trickle it down to, let's say, rural areas, these are women who go flat out in the bush cutting down trees for firewood and just to make charcoal, so they earn something or money to feed the family, to take the children to school. Now, in terms of SDGs, how can we help these women so that they don't go, they don't tamper with the environment, looking at them that are not even educated, some of them from rural areas? Yes, ma'am.
Okay, who else? Halima, still, the microphone is unmuted, but you are not speaking, so we can take someone else. I guess that's it. If there are no more, questions, I guess Her Excellency can start answering.
Is it okay if I just come through quickly?
Okay, sure.
Thank you so much, Your Excellency. Good afternoon and colleagues from over Africa. My name is Rahadi, I'm from South Africa. I just wanted to ask, in terms of green procurement, does it get factored in when it comes to other processes that we're busy with on environment? And are there any other African countries that are successful in implementing green procurement? Because that's something that we tend to struggle with in South Africa. And is it only applicable to certain services or commodities that one wants to procure for any institution? Thank you so much.
There are no more questions, so Your Excellency, go ahead and answer those questions.
Okay, thank you so much, Hanan. And I would like to thank all those who asked the questions. I'll start with the first questions. First question, which was asked by, I didn't know the name, but she was asking about the issue. There is a project which is ongoing, and it was brought by the African Development Bank, and it aims to fit the African strategy. But she's asking, what is the role of SDG? To my thinking, I think this is the continuous progress towards implementation of SDG, because you can see, looking at it, you'll see it's a follow-up program, which in one way or another, it supports the implementation of the SDG, because having the SDGs, we also have the targets. And looking at the each SDG, looking at their targets, they mentioned different, one SDG can impact different aspects. It impacts different sectors. So there are lots of movements, lots of projects which are ongoing, but I'm sure that this, the role of SDG here, it's just the support, but you cannot isolate, you cannot talk SDG without talking about these movements or any other project which is ongoing, whether it's an infrastructure project, whether it's a mining project, whether it's a project dealing with the African issues, with the agricultural issues, whether it's a project dealing with the financial issues, because all these issues were mentioned into the SDG. So the role of SDG here is when they are doing the evaluation and monitoring and evaluation, this is where now the SDG will come in and say, and they look at this this strategy and see if it's well implemented. I am not sure if I've answered your question, but this is according to my thinking, because I'm not that conversant about this strategy which started on 2015. And the second question was from Susie, where she was talking. She asked also about the role of SDGs, especially when we look at the measures which were put in agricultural sector. Looking at it, you can see that one of the aim, one of the target of SDG is to make sure, that countries, especially from national level to the continental level, they integrate the policies and laws. So looking at this, at the way things are, there is no way agriculture cannot be impacted or cannot be affected by the implementation of SDG. And you can see there are specific SDG to deal with the agricultural issues. And you see agriculture also, it is very wide. Implementing the agriculture activities, it has the impact to other SDGs, which does not mention the agriculture, which does not mention the agriculture. But on the other hand, implementing the agriculture or working on the agriculture or either the measures to which have been taken to put agriculture in place, they affect the SDGs. I have another person who asked the question, who is Edna? That for her, it was not a question. She had a proposal that we really need to have the policy in hand, which deals with the women participation, especially on the issues to do with the implementation of the SDGs. But she had a concern on this, how women are being supported financially, and also how women are being given the opportunity to participate in the implementation of SDGs without affecting the other. For me, I think we really need to establish, to have the policies in place from the national level to make sure that especially the policymakers or the lawmakers understand all these issues first, so that they can support the movement. Once you have the policy in place, the same policy or laws will have to talk about the issues of having even the financing mechanism to the groups, to different groups, especially women and the young people, so that once they are supported and they are aware of the environmental and SDG issues, it will be very easy to get things in place. I think this is what I could answer you, Edna, as of now. Also, we have the question from Hazel. She asked how best can we help the women since they are on the ground and you can see they are doing different practices to affect the environment and doing it. Also, they play a very big part on the climate issues. Mine is the same thing, that first of all, we need to provide the awareness. I know it's not easy to say that we shall provide awareness, because we know there are some women who are still either in the very, very interior villages where we cannot reach them. But to me, I think we can also go through policymakers to ensure that education system includes the awareness on the environmental protection. And once this young generation grew up, understands that there is a problem doing the cutting trees, and maybe they can even become innovative to bring their own innovations, especially bringing in the using of alternative energy, so that their parents or themselves, they should not cut trees from their forests. Also, we can use the same policymakers to include the financing mechanism into the laws, that maybe we need to get this certain percent to the women who wants to survive from their lives, something which is very complicated within the African context, but at least if something is being appreciated by especially the lawmakers, it is very easy to do the fundraising and support the women to either do other activities, or they can do business, a small business, they can become entrepreneurs so that they get sources of, they get money and they use gas. Rather than going to the forest and cut trees or use charcoal. And also, it's all about realizing the issues and put them into the national policies or international laws. And from there, maybe we can tackle the problem. The last question was from Rahat. I didn't get it clear. She was talking about the issue of how South Africa can be can get support, they can get support, or they can be leaded on to join the green movement. Maybe Hanan, you can assist on that. But for me here, I don't know much. Maybe because there are a lot of women movements who are dealing with, who are members of this of the movement, it's very easy to be linked with them. And because for them, they have, I'm sure they have maybe a group or they have an organization from there, from South Africa. It's very easy to be linked with the other groups so that they can understand on how other women are implementing on their working, or they are doing their things. I think so far I've answered all the questions which were asked before. And if something is not clear, I'm here to clarify.
One question by the first participant who asked the first question. She said you answered one question only and she asked you two questions. Hassana? She asked two questions and on the chat box she said you answered only one. So
okay, maybe she can ask me the second question. So maybe I missed the question.
So Hassana, could you please ask the question again? Yes, it's correct. Okay. Could you please unmute yourself and ask the question again? Raise your hand, Hassana. Unmute. Raise your hand, please. Hassana, raise your hand, please. Hassana? Yes. I give you the floor. You can go ahead and ask your question again.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, we can hear you. Hear me?
Okay, my second question was that I need to understand the legal implications of those member countries that refuse to work towards the agenda 2030 or 2063. In your parliament or at the global, at the regional or national level? Thank you very much. The legal implication. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, thank you so much. I think I don't know if these countries have refused to implement the SDG. Before I answer, like if it's legal, it has a legal implication or not, because you might find some of the countries really they really wish to implement the SDGs and the goals, but there are a lot of issues which are ongoing. Ongoing in these countries. There are some countries which are being affected by different ways. There are countries which are they are having the issues with the conflicts. There are countries which are being affected by the different disasters. So we cannot say that those countries which have failed to implement that they refused, but I'm very sure that during the agreement, there are some directives that these countries must implement what they signed for, especially those members who are members of United Nations. But once the country has failed to implement whatever they're supposed to implement, especially the sustainable development issues, most of them, I'm sure, they are given time frame. They are given time frame for implementation. And some of them are not indicated as they've been implemented, but they've started, most of them, they started the implementation. but they have not reached the end. So that's why they are appearing as if they have not implemented, because if you have to appear as the country which has implemented, you have to show the progress. If you are ongoing, or maybe if you are still lagging behind by far, you are going to be considered as the country which has not yet implemented the SDG. This is what I understand. But on the legal implication, once someone is in the has agreed with the United Nations agreement, that means that person is, that country or the state is supposed to be answerable. I'll take the example of the at the regional level where I'm working. There are a lot of policies, there are laws which have been passed, and these policies, they relate direct to the implementation of SDGs, and the countries are supposed to implement. But on the other hand, the countries have to implement whether the laws or the projects according to the agreement and the memorandum of understanding, in perspective, considering the perspective of the specific region. So once the country has not implemented, we have the summit level, where the summit members, who are the presidents of the countries, they have to sit down and look at the issues and see if these issues are really practical. And if are not practical, they'll come back to the council member or council members, who are the ministers, and bring it back. And maybe sometimes they rework on the policies. They bring it to the council, and the council bring it to the parliament, so that the parliament can either redraft or they can amend the present policies or the present weather guidelines of implementation, so that these policies suit the proper environment which has been analyzed by the summit members. But the summit members cannot decide by themselves. They also work with the technical team, which the technical team conducts evaluation and monitoring on the implementation. And after that, they provide the reports. But on the other side, as a policymaker, we have a responsibility to summon the summit or the council, because the council are the spokesperson, they are there to represent the summit. Sometimes we summon them, and also the secretariat, because they are the implementers of the projects. We summon them at the parliament, especially during the assembly time, them on why these projects are not in place or why these projects are not implemented. And once they answer the questions and they answer what is really the situation, we always give them the time frame for implementation. And what we do after that, we go back and conduct our oversight activity, looking at how these projects are being implemented and how are they impacting the people of the community. I don't know on the other side of the regions, but on the other side of the continent, but at the EAC level, that's how things are done. And sometimes there are some activists or civil society organization, whereby they bring the petition, especially when they see things are not moving. The implementation of projects maybe are lagging behind, especially targeting the SDGs. There are lots of people bringing the petition, and they petition the assembly, and the assembly brings the petition to the house and discuss it to the house, and summon the secretariat, the secretary general of the community, so that he brings the reasons of why these projects are not implemented. And if it's the issue to do with the finance, the next budget session, we always consider the specific project and put some money into that project so that that project can be implemented. So that's how we solve the issues within the East African community region.
Thank you so much, Your Excellency. And now I think it's time for the group photo. So I will ask all participants to open their cameras so that we can see you. Raise your hands so that we can allow you to open your cameras so that we can take a group photo with Her Excellency, Engineer Pamel. Thank you. Yes, keep raising your hands so that we can allow you to open the camera. Yes, yeah, Susan, I can see you. Who else would like to join? Hassana? Yes. Yes. Dr. Ibn, I can see you. Hello, Abbasi? Badia, yes. Who else? Who else would like to join us? Yes, just raise your
camera. Is not open. My camera is not open.
Yes, immediately. It will be opened immediately. Just try now. Yes, we have plenty of hands. Great. Oh, yes, Dr. Wafa, I can see you as well. Inna, Ubi, Nila.
Hi, Dr. Hanan, how are you?
Hello, dear, hello. Yes, a wonderful group photo. Let's have this view, the bigger view. Stop sharing your screen, please. Stop sharing your screen. Yes. Are you ready? Yes, we're waiting for some. Want to join? Hazel? Yes. Abby, we're waiting for you.
I can't see the camera. I can't see the camera.
Ask them if you can log out to log in again.
Can I log out and in after?
I want to join too. I can't see the camera. I'm seeing others, but I'm not seeing myself.
Me too. I can't see the camera.
Ask them if you can log out.
I've unmuted myself. Alu have unmuted herself. She also wants to snap.
Hello, can I leave the meeting and join again?
Yes, she's arriving. She's arriving. Yes,
leave the name. Hello, ma'am. Can I out and in so that I'm on
camera? Don't you see?
We will take this.
Please out for join.
Bonjour, tout le monde. Je m'appelle Aïssa Tougouaro, je suis de... de la Guinée. Je suis nutritionniste au ministère de la Santé.
We will have this one group photo and then we will take another one. One, two, three.
Where will I be?
Okay.
I was not part of this, so please help me out to be the part of the next one.
You are in this one already.
Okay. Hello.
To join.
Alu did not join.
But I can see you.
And I'm not seeing myself.
Then I'm laughing. Can you see her?
I can't see myself. I'm seeing other people.
Me too. I can't see myself.
Can you see yourself now?
Send me where I can see myself. I'm also not seeing myself.
Unlike you people that can't even see no one. I'm only seeing me and the letter.
I can't see myself here.
Move the arrow on the right here. Yes.
Window, you are in.
I can't see myself. Oh my gosh.
Yes. I'm seeing other people.
How can I can see the camera, me too.
Oh dear.
Oh my goodness, I can see you now. Most of you, I guess.
But I don't know how to log in with the video. How do I do it?
I don't see, I just see my camera. I don't see other people.
I guess
it might be. Yes.
So it's the thing. Yes, we can see you. You're pretty. So it's time to me. Thank Her Excellency.
Are you seeing me?
Presentation. Thank you so much for being with us.
Where am I? Oh, where am I?
Can you hear me? Thank you so much for being with us.
I'm not seeing myself.
Yes, I can hear you.
And it's a great opportunity that we are all here together as participants, so we can say bye to Her Excellency, and we have some concluding remarks. Thank you so much. Oh,
thank you, Her Excellency. Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for allowing me to present to you. And I hope all of you enjoyed.